Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the gate solution and discussion. And this is lecture number 46. We are going to discuss the questions from the gate question paper in fluid kinematics, part 1. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the questions on the fluid mechanics. We continue with the subject fluid mechanics, and this is fluid kinematics. There are plenty of questions on the fluid kinematics. We will take one by one from various gate question paper. This question is from 1994 question paper. Steam line, path line and streak lines are virtually identical for uniform flow, flow of ideal fluid, steady flow and non-uniform flow. The correct option is steady flow. For steady flow, steam line, path line and streak lines are virtually identical. So, the answer to this question is steady flow. The second question is again from 1994 question paper. In your flow field, the steam line and equipotential lines, there are four options, are parallel, cut at an angle, are orthogonal everywhere in the field, flow field, cut orthogonal except at the stagnation points. So, this is the flow field where steam lines and the equipotential lines are given here. It is clear that the product of slope of the equipotential line and steam line at the point of intersection is equal to minus 1. Thus, equipotential line and the steam lines intersect each other orthogonally at all points of intersection. The correct answer is option C. So, the in a flow field, the steam lines and the equipotential lines cut orthogonal or orthogonal everywhere in the field. That means they are perpendicular to each other. Next question again, 1994 question paper. For a fluid element in a two-dimensional flow field, xy plane, it will undergo translation only, translation and rotation, translation and deformation only. So, for a two-dimensional flow in a xy plane, the fluid is not rotating. The fluid element may have translation, deformation and rotation, but for potential flow, so the three movements are possible, but for potential flow, the fluid element can have translation and deformation only, not rotation. So, the answer is translation and deformation, option C. The next question, the existence of velocity potential implies that there are four options. Option A, fluid is in continuum, fluid is irrotational, fluid is ideal and fluid is compressible. When velocity potential exists, then the fluid is irrotational. So, the option is option B, the fluid is irrotational. Circulation is defined as line integral of tangential component of velocity about a dash. So, the circulation, the definition for circulation, flow along a closed curve or contour is called as circulation. So, this is, the answer is closed curve or contour. Circulation is defined as line integral of tangential component of velocity about a closed curve or a contour. Next question from 2004 question paper. A fluid flow is represented by a velocity field V vector equal to Ax I vector plus Ay j vector, where A is constant. The equation of streamline passing through the point 1, 2, x equal to 1, y equal to 2 is, options are given, x minus 2y equal to 0, 2x plus y equal to 0, 2x minus y equal to 0, x plus 2y equal to 0. The correct answer is option C, 2x minus y equal to 0. We will see how in the next slide. So, this is the velocity vector given. V vector equal to Axi plus Ayj. The equation for the streamline is dx by u equal to dy by v. So, from the equation, given equation, u equal to Ax, v equal to Ay. Substituting for u and v, so dx by Ax equal to dy by Ay. integrating this equation, dx by ax equal to a is getting cancelled on both sides. So, dx by x equal to dy by y. So, integrating ln x equal to logarithmic of y plus constant c. So, rearranging x by y equal to c. It is another constant. For x equal to 1 and y equal to 2, c equal to 1 by 2. So, substituting c equal to 1 by 2 and rearranging the term, the equation is 2x minus y equal to 0. That is the answer. Next question from 2005 question paper. The velocity component in the x and y directions of a two-dimensional potential flow are u and v respectively. Then dou u by dou y is equal to dou v by dou x minus dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y minus dou v by dou y. So the potential flow remains irrotational flow. For irrotational flow, cross velocity gradient are equal. So dou u by dou y equal to dou v by dou x. So the answer is option A, dou v by dou x. For irrotational flow, dou u by dou y equal to dou v by dou x. Next question from 2006 question paper. In a two-dimensional velocity field, the velocities are u and v along the x and y directions respectively. The convective acceleration along x direction is given by. So, u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y, u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y, u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y. Option D, v into dou u by dou x plus u into dou u by dou y. So, the correct answer is option A, u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y. We will see how. The acceleration for steady flow conditions is given by ax equal to u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. Acceleration in the y direction, ay equal to u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y plus w into dou v by dou z. In the z direction, az equal to u into dou w by dou x plus v into dou w by dou x plus w into dou w by dou z. For two-dimensional flow field, aw equal to dou u by dou z. Then the convective acceleration along the x direction is given by. So, ax equal to u into dou u by dou x plus dou v by v into dou v by dou y. So, this is for acceleration for two-dimensional flow field in the x direction. Next question, again from 2006 question paper. A two-dimensional flow field has velocities along x and y directions given by u equal to x square t plus and v equal to minus 2xyt respectively, where t is the time. The equation of the streamline is, there are four options given. Option A, x square y equal to constant. Option B, x y square equal to constant. Option C, x y equal to constant. And option D, not possible to determine. The answer is option A, x square y equal to constant. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, we are given u equal to x square t and v equal to minus 2xyt. So, for the equation for streamline is dx by u equal to dy by v. So, substituting for u and v, dx by x square t equal to dy by minus 2xyt. So, integrating this equation. So, the t is getting cancelled. So, we will have integral dx by x square equal to minus integral dy by 2xy. Again, x is also getting cancelled. 1x is getting cancelled. So, it is 2 into integral dx by x equal to minus integral dy by y. 2 ln x equal to minus ln y, logarithmic of y plus constant c. So, rearranging the terms, x square y equal to c. It is the answer. X square y equal to constant. That is the equation for streamline. Next question from 2007 question paper. In a steady flow through a nozzle, the flow velocity on the nozzle axis is given by u equal to uo into 1 plus 3 x by l, where x is the distance along the axis of the nozzle from its inlet plane and l is the length of the nozzle. The time required for the fluid particle on the axis to travel from the inlet to the exit plane of the nozzle is given by, there are four options are given, A equal to L by UO, B equal to L by 3 UO into logarithmic of L, logarithmic of 4, C, option C, 4 by, L by 4 UO and option D, L by 2.5 UO. So, the correct answer is L by 3 UO into logarithmic of 4. We will see how in the next slide. So, this is the nozzle, inlet section and the exit section, the length of the nozzle is L. So, U is given by dx by dt, UO into 1 plus 3x by L, separating the variable and integrating. So, integral 0 to L, 1 by UO into 1 plus 3x by L dx equal to integral 0 to t dt. So, integrating, 1 by UO is a constant, 1 by UO logarithmic of 1 plus 3x by L into L by 3 to the between the limit 0 to L and the left right hand side it is t. So, substituting the limit, so L by 3 UO into 1 plus 3 minus logarithmic of 1 plus 0, log 1 base anything equal to 0, that is equal to right hand equal to t. So, 3 L by 3 UO into logarithmic of 4 by 1 equal to 4, this term becomes 0. So, the answer is t equal to L by 3 UO into logarithmic of 4, that is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2008 question paper, for a continuity equation given by del V, the operator del V vector equal to 0 to be valued, where V vector in the wave vector is the velocity vector, which one of the following is necessary condition? It should be a steady flow, irrotational flow, inviscid flow and incompressible flow. So, del V vector equal to 0 means divergence of the velocity vector is equal to 0, that is, dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y plus dou w by dou z equal to 0, and this equation is applicable for incompressible flow for both steady and unsteady condition. So, the correct answer is option D, the condition del v vector equal to 0, it is applicable for incompressible flow. The next question from GATE 2011 question paper, the streamline and an equipotential line in a flow field are parallel to each other, are perpendicular to each other, intersected at an acute angle, are identical. So, the streamline in a flow field, the streamline and the equipotential line in the flow field are perpendicular to each other. So, the correct answer is option B. So, the streamline and an equipotential line in a flow field are perpendicular to each other. Next question is from 2014 question paper. For an incompressible flow field, V vector, velocity vector, V vector, which one of the following condition must be satisfied? So, del V vector equal to 0, del into V vector equal to 0, del V vector into V vector equal to 0, dou V vector by dou t plus del V vector into V vector equal to 0. So, for an incompressible flow, del V vector equal to 0 to be satisfied. So, option A is the correct answer. Next question, in a flow field which has convective acceleration is a steady uniform flow, an unsteady uniform flow, a steady non-uniform flow and unsteady non-uniform flow. So, we must know the total acceleration equal to local acceleration plus convective acceleration. So, in fact, A equal to dou E by dou T plus U into dou U by dou X. And we have V into, so this is, there are, this term, the velocity, differentiation of velocity with respect to time is called as local acceleration, and differentiation of U into dou U by dou X is called as convective acceleration, and this is velocity varies with respect to time, and this is velocity varies with respect to position. Now, here, it is convective acceleration, when you have only convective acceleration, only this term. So, only the second term is available in the acceleration term, that means it is a steady non-uniform flow. So, steady non-uniform flow is, for steady non-uniform flow, we have only the convective acceleration. There is no local acceleration for the steady flow. So, option C is the correct answer. The next question from 2015 question paper, in the fluid, if the fluid velocity for a potential flow is given by v of xy equal to u of xy into I vector plus v of xy into j vector with the usual notations, then the slope of the potential line at xy is option A, v by u, option B, minus u by v, option C, v square by u square, option D, u by v. So, the correct answer is option B, minus u by v. We will see how in the next slide. So, this is the equation for streamline, dx by u equal to dy by v. So, slope of the streamline is dy by dx equal to v by u. So, rearranging dy by dx equal to v by u. So, we know that the streamline, slope of the streamline and the equipotential line, they meet, when the product of these two equal to minus 1. So, they are perpendicular to each other. So, dy by dx of the streamline multiplied by dy by dx of the potential line. So, dy by dx is slope of the streamline multiplied by slope of the potential line is equal to minus 1. We have the slope of the streamline. So, substitute v by u into dy by dx of the potential line equal to minus 1. So, rearranging the term, so dy by dx, slope of the potential line equal to minus u by v. That is the answer. The next question from 2016 question paper, the volumetric flow rate per unit width between two streamlines having stream function psi 1 and psi 2 is, four options are given. Option A, modulus of psi 1 plus psi 2. Option B, psi 1 into psi 2. Option C, psi 1 divided by psi 2. And option D, psi 1 minus psi 2. So, the difference between two streamline function given by volumetric flow rate. So, difference. So, the option D is the correct answer. So, the volumetric flow rate between the stream functions equal to modulus of psi 1 minus psi 2 is the correct answer. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the fluid mechanics and machinery subject. You can read the book to get the clarity on the subject. At the same time, I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You refer to the video lectures in the fluid mechanics so that it will help you to solve the problem or the questions in the 8 question paper. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comment box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video on the solution for the gate question paper in the fluid kinematics. Until then, bye-bye.